Hey guys, it's Gadget, and like I said, the camera angles are different and everything. As you can see, this is starting to get a lot better. It's just I'm not used to where this camera is right now. I usually have it on top of the computer, but due to the way the new desk and everything is, I can't put it in certain areas and everything. Okay, and I don't know where to begin because I don't know anymore what to do. I graduated from college, there's no jobs. Unless you move out, and even the people that are in other states are saying the same thing. There's no jobs in their states. And it's like all I have left are these blogs and basically trying to find work, trying to find things, trying to do things because of what's wrong with me and everything. And like officially on record, it's costochondritis, but it is a form of fibromyalgia. I mean, I get good days and bad days. I'm on natural pills because the stuff they give you can kill you. Yeah, I don't like when something says can cause death. All right. And besides, I live in New York City. You don't need a car, you don't need anything. You got a lot of public transportation, but thanks to our new mayor, who is blind as a bat about what's going on in the world today, it's not safe. It's like living when I grew up as a baby and like or the kid as a kid in the 70s and 80s, you didn't go out and everything. So pretty soon we may have a summer of Sam again, if you get my drift and everything, because this is getting out of hand. So basically, there's a lot going on in my state, everything else, and with me dealing with things. And then, what else is there? Well, you know, you have the problems when you've got like an IQ of whatever and everything. You've got all this other stuff. You can't find work because you don't do well on tests. See, there's a weird thing about New York. For you to get a job, especially with state and local governments and city, you have to take a test. Now, the problem with that is I'm not a test taker. I never was. My school never really did tests. I did verbal testing. I did all this other stuff and everything, right? Can't do Scantrons, can't do anything. I hate them. I mess up the computers. I mean, they did a test where you had to see about like I forget what it's called, but it's to measure like how fast you are on a computer, all this stuff. Yeah, I broke the computer. I overloaded it. Like, they found out that the reason I can see and it's about 1% of 1,000 people can see this, where you can see the hourglasses, like this comic book that was out. You can see the hourglass hidden in the stopwatch and everything. It's a rare form of color blindness. And the problem is, mine over exaggerates, as one eye doctor put it, that's why I can do those eye games and everything else really quick and win them and stuff. Like, I can see the lines and money and stuff. Like, you can't, like, it's like almost having like ultraviolet eyes. But it's weird. Everything. So basically, like, I have all these good attributes, everything, talents and stuff. And I can't put them to use because of how everything is around here. The city's not safe. My family, my mom is getting worse. Her bipolar manic depression, which she every time gets diagnosed and everything, every time, like, and everything. And I'm sorry, I'm gonna sneeze because that's why I'm blinking my eyes and everything. I know you people do these things with lying and all this other stuff. You watch for hand signals, you watch for touching noses and all this other stuff and everything. Yeah, gotta stop that because most people have these things where they have little quirks and things. So I'll explain that in other videos too. Because when you grow up abused and everything, you start getting little things like I said, for the last 10 years, I've been trying to shake off what that family across the hall did to me. And I am so glad I got kicked out of that family. You don't know how much I've been praising, but people still punish me for it. People still think it should be 1, 2, 3, you're good. No, you're not good. You know? Like today, I'm a little chipper because it's like I'm sitting here going, after seeing a YouTube video from this lady and everything, I gotta get her name again. I put her on Facebook. She's very positive. She's very, I don't know how you would say it, like what guys would call voluptuous, or I call like normal and everything. Very like big boned or anything, right? I was looking for a video because this is another thing I'm gonna talk about, how some guys get mad when girls lose weight. And then you have the vice versa where the guys get mad when the girls gain weight and everything. So this is another topic I want to bring up too later on and stuff, but I'm rambling because I don't know what to do first. Because I'm just so amazed at people how they can lie bold faced to me and everything and play games and stuff to the point where it's got to stop, you know? It's gotta be 50-50, like Phineas and Ferb. If you love someone, you meet them halfway. Things like that type of things. Because I don't play nice anymore. I'm a dragon Scorpio who's part Phoenix and everything. So yeah. I mean, there's so many things that right now I'm amazed at people with, because the one thing I talk about in these videos is not to be a follower, but be a leader. And not to create followers being a leader, to create other leaders and everything. So this is where I think I may be dealing with this right now, because it just shows me that maybe the person I'm dealing with right now, I can't have in my life. I can't deal with it. No matter how many times we fix things or anything, no matter how many times he claims he tries, or even some friends I have, the same thing too and stuff. So let's see. How do I put this and everything? Because I really don't know where to begin, because it just amazes me, because it ties into a lot of things. I mean, you want to talk about someone that I'm speaking to that actually encompasses so many different stereotypes, or I don't see with my dyslexia, I don't know the word to say that I know it's in here. It's a word to mean that, okay, you're a follower, you copy what they want, you to like to be liked, you want to do what they do. I think I'm saying it right and everything. An example would be like on Facebook right now, there's a thing going around. My friend here in the United States did it, as well as I just found out some people in Europe are doing, where sometimes Facebook is so negative and everything that they're flooding it with pictures of things like kittens and things like that and stuff, right? Now, I watch my friends and I see who does what and everything, and I speak to them about it. Because one of my friends asked me, "Oh, like my profile, I'll give you a superhero, right?" No. Why do I have to flood Facebook with things? Why do I have to follow you? I like hearing if people have good days and bad days. It tells me what's going on and that maybe I can help, not try to avoid it. And that's called avoidance, when you try to avoid things. That's why we're all the way we are today and everything messed up and no one talks to anybody. So I was very shocked to find out how this person put something. All of a sudden, the profile picture changed from a colorful picture, I'm not going to say what it is because it might be copyrighted, to a superhero. And I joked and I said, "Oh, my friend is doing the same thing too." And they said to me, "Well, my friend in Georgia and this and everything, my friend this with an A, the first name starts with an A, I'm doing it because of her." I went, "What?" And this wasn't even spoken to me. This was typed on Skype. So I said, "You're a follower." The minute I said that, it must have pissed him off or something, because he said, then goes, "No, just joking or whatever. I'm doing it for myself." No. No, you are. So I mean, okay, how do you put this on Facebook? Facebook gives you people who you think you know and everything. They want you to make connections and everything. So I'm watching the camera, so why my eyes are like this, because I don't trust this setup I have here because of the way it is, because I'm not used to this new setup. So it's like, who you know or anything. Like he was very shocked too about some other people that my friends are friends with, but I'm not friends with his friends. You see what I mean? That's the odd thing about Facebook. So supposedly when I figured out who it was, because that person had kept coming up on my page too, it's like a lot of his friends he has friends with, Facebook wants me to try to be friends with them. And like I said, there's some I will not be. Some of them are very slimy, very mean, nasty, vindictive, and everything. Some are part of something that I'm very pissed off about him about and everything, because one of my friends said this to me because they noticed I started losing weight again. And this has happened to me before, and I wanted to talk to girls about this too. It seems some guys like girls who are very overweight, or at least whatever. Me, I was never overweight. It was all the medicines I was put on when I was younger for my knee, with all the steroids and everything, not going out because of mom being paranoid about us going out and all this stuff, right? So basically, when I did finally ever get to go out and I was doing my acting, I lost a lot of weight. I was very thin. I was back to the weight I was supposed to be growing up. And I mean, then I got really too thin because they were trying to keep me for camera purposes, because it adds pounds and everything. I was below a weight that was good for me. So I went back up to my weight, all of a sudden found out I got sick with an ovarian cyst, a dermoid. Ever since then, my weight fluctuates because they messed up my hormones. To top it off, then I have the costochondritis, which is part of fibromyalgia. Then I have an intradermal lump in my knee. I have other things that are wrong with me that all these medicines just keep putting weight on me, puffiness, I call it, and everything, right? I went from a 36C to a 38D because of all this, which some reason guys like that better now, but I don't care. I don't like it because I can't find anything that fits. But at the same time, I like the fact that I can actually fill out a dress better now than I used to. So I don't care about my weight. It's just I'm tired of these things where people follow and follow and not are leaders. Now, back to what I was talking about. So basically, I went and checked and everything, and I've noticed a lot on his page. He goes for the girl that's very, I don't know how to put it. My friend said it to me. I don't like saying the way they said it. So I don't know if that's his subconscious or anything, the same way like some of my other friends have done it and everything, because he's not alone. There are guys that are like this. And I don't care if he yells at me right now or ditches me again because of what he, it's his own insecurities. I don't have any insecurities. What I have is tired of being told in harassing emails that I'm not supposed to be near him. Tired of having him put me in the background because he is busy and everything when he's the one that wanted to come back to me this time and everything because see I don't go back to him. This has made the third or fourth fight we've had where he's had to come back to me for odd reasons or anything. This time I put him on probation to see what he would act. He went back to his old ways. So this is where my contemplating is. Even last night, I asked a couple questions and everything and stuff, and I still. So it makes me think now that when he first met me, I was, well, do I even have, is the bed near me? No, is it? No, it's not near me. I would have shown you my school ID, okay? When I first, when he first met me, I was a little bit chunkier. I know you could see in these videos that you could see sometimes I'm a little puffy or anything and stuff, but that's the medicine, up and down, up and down. Now that I'm walking more, doing more things these past years and everything, because I'm not giving up what I did do, because I don't mind being curvy and thick and everything. I just want to be in better health, right? And everything. He's starting to lose a little interest and just keeping me around for fun, if you get my drift. Meaning, oh, you're fun to talk to, haha, be a good girl, blah, 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 bye. And it's annoying because I sit here and I watch girls either starve themselves or overeat because of what guys tell them. And I was sitting here making myself a wreck because I have no way to strangle these people who are sending me the harassing emails. But he's not doing anything about it. So what am I going to do about it? I'm basically either gonna have to sit him down and confront him one day, or this is why I think guys fear me too. I'm going to do my own research and find out if he's a lying bastard to me. I don't care if he hates me right now. I don't really care because he got on with his life when he ditched me and blocked me six back on December 7, 2014. He asked me to come back. He asked me if he could come back. I could have kept him away, but you see, that's the difference with me. I'm not vindictive and mean. I don't throw things away. I give you a chance, no matter how many there are. But your trust factor just keeps going down and down and down. He's good for entertainment purposes, because I love when he tries to get out of things. Same way, like my other friends and everything and stuff, who all promised, oh, look, we like you. We're going to try to date you. Oh, no, I can't do that. So, I know I'm off tangent and things and stuff, and I'm like looking at the thing because I'm surprised that, with everything. But it's just crazy to think that we all destroy ourselves for love. We all destroy ourselves for looking pretty. We all destroy ourselves for looking ugly. We destroy ourselves for things like illnesses and everything. I'm sorry. It's just that it's dusty in here. It's like 90 degrees outside. The air conditioner is and everything. And I just tried to clean a bedroom in 90 degree weather. Yes. Which, yeah, that's another thing. He still claims the visa he can't get, that he has to wait for mommy and daddy to do it. 32 years old in a couple of days. You know what he's doing? He's got friends coming in October. He's got his birthday. He has got other people there. He's doing videos for another YouTube channel. He's doing okay. I don't think he's anytime quickly gonna decide to show up, right? Nah, ladies, guys, right? I really am just like these are all venting right now because I mean, I have so many things that I can talk about when I finally get organized. Because that's another thing. You see a blanket there, you see everything. Because of school work and everything, and with the way my building is and my neighbors and everything, I can't do much. So I have to do it in a time frame. Like now, this whole month, maybe up until October, I'm going to be a hermit because my unemployment was cut for the month. Okay, they're approving it, and it's only like $30, but you know what? It's $30 I could pay a bill with. Con Ed raised their rates for the air conditioner, so I have to pay a $400 Con Ed bill. Love that one, right? Then I have to pay rent, I have to pay everything else, all by myself here, like everyone else in the world. Then there are those people like him who live at home thinking, I'll go get an apartment and everything. They don't know how lucky they got it made. Wonder why I can't visit him? Wonder why I can't do anything? $2,600 a month. That's not even with a food bill because there's no money for food. Welcome to New York, where the poor are living poor and starving and eating gummy bears because it's cheap. Yeah, gummy bears and soda. I can't take it anymore. No one wants to work with me. The ones who do want to work with me have their own problems to deal with. So that's why I get upset when I see things like you wanting to be with me, but you're not making the effort. Or you're going to other people's pages because, all right, fine and great, your friends and everything. But you're doing something that in my mind thinks you're more of a follower than a leader. How are you going to stand up for things? The saddest thing was, I asked him a very simple question about how he feels about me. Physically, mentally, and I think physically, I am going to be honest with you. Any guy that meets me, and I think you guys will understand that, physically, there is a reaction. I see it, okay? And most of you know what I'm talking about because I don't want little kids hearing about this, okay? He says he doesn't get that reaction with me. He likes me, but he doesn't get that reaction. Nothing does this. You get it? Okay? So, yet, other people get that reaction when they talk with me, see me, that seeing how pretty I am and everything. It only makes me think that after seeing some of the other people's pages and everything that he supposedly interacts more with, I should say, it's either because I've lost weight, not doing what he says, confronting him on everything, or basically just he's trying to pull a fast one and hide me again. He gets too busy for me. That's another thing. When someone is too busy for you, they don't want you around. I'm busy, go away. I'm busy, go away. Can I have a hug, mommy? I'm busy, go away. Can I have a hug? No, I'm busy, go away. Oh, can you help me with my homework? No, I'm busy, go away. Ask your father. Go, I'm busy, I'll go. Okay. Grandparents dead. Can I have a hug? No. Go away. You get the idea. Same thing with friends I've ditched. Well, not, I call it ditched because I had to ditch them because you try to get rid of them and they didn't go away. And I don't want him thinking that's the type of friend I am, that you have to like make sure to ditch me to go away. But these were ones that were like vampires, if you get my drift. Those are the other ones you gotta watch, are the vampires. Oh, look, can you come over and help me? Oh, well, sure, no problem. Oh, look, I'm stuck. My bedroom. Can you? No. I'm so, oh, I'm tired. I. I could go on with a list. That's why I'm saying, like, I have so many ideas for videos and things like that. And I didn't realize this was 20 minutes already and stuff. I don't want to try to make these long videos. I want to do live things, but the live ones are going to go crazy because I want to do tarot card readings and things like that. But you see where I'm getting at? It's like, I need to break these down into little videos about followers. I need to break it down about what guys prefer from what I'm hearing from other girls and guys as well, because I don't believe that it's okay. How do I put this? I believe everyone should be miserable. Let's do it that way, because I don't want to. See, that's the thing. I don't. I will offend people. It's just that I don't want to offend YouTube right now because I'm in good standing, and I really need this because this is cheaper than therapy. Plus, it gets my point across. All right. So I'm gonna work on some things, but I just wanted to give you a heads up. Like, it's at the point now where I really cannot believe what's been going on these past couple of days since I put that other video on. And like I said, I don't care. We fight, we do whatever and anything. I don't care. It's just he's going back into his habits. And I'm getting lost in the shuffle again. Especially when people are sending harassing emails to me. So I know he's trying to keep me quiet because he doesn't want to make trouble with his friends. You know, I tell his friends, "Ah, fanglo." Yes, I'm half Italian. And I'm half Irish. So I've, yeah. He doesn't know what he's getting. And I told you I'm a scorpion, I'm a witch, I'm a psychic. Yeah. Take me as I am or walk away. I'll talk to you guys soon, but I wanted to just give you an update before I do any separate videos and stuff. All right. Find my mouse, and I will see you guys soon.